Gloria. Ken Bruce.
Has it really been so long? I've only been away for 2 weeks, and they've all forgotten already. Never mind. I'll soon remember why I'm here. That's old Lionel. Good old Lionel. Lionel Richie, all night long. Which is just what we are going to be providing for you. A long night. Oh, it's going to get longer, too. I'm here till 1 o'clock, and then Peter Dixon is on until 3. That's not a good enough reason to switch off now and go to bed. I don't know what is. Well, of course, I haven't been here for 2 weeks. There have been the Olympian efforts of Terry Wogan. But now, your small board is back.
BBC Radio 2, Ken Bruce.
Hello, this is our second last Saturday together. I may cry. On the other hand, I may not. This is still number one. Remarkable record, eh? Number one still. The biggest selling single of all time, apparently. Something like almost 2.5 million copies sold in this country. And didn't I hear something rather unpleasant about what was happening in Singapore about that record? Somebody's pirating them and selling them off for their own profits. Ah, well. Peace and goodwill to all men. Let's think of something nicer. Ah.
Ken Bruce.
Here we are, then. Another Saturday night. My last Saturday night on Radio 2. Don't know what I've done. Must be something I've done over the past year they didn't like, but there it is. I have to go now. Well, I'll wait till midnight, okay? In the meantime, we'll all have a little party before New Year with Russ Abbott. There he is, Russ Abbott. Vince Prince and the Tone Deaf. Atmosphere. Good record, huh? Great one. And I was watching Russ Abbott on television tonight. He was doing his See You, Jimmy, you know, this Scottish bit he does. And he was making remarks about what Scots get up to at New Year. As we know, only a few days away, Hogmanay. He seemed to be implying that people in Scotland drank a lot in New Year and got incapable and things like that. Well, I found that extremely offensive. Accurate, but offensive. I shall be completely sober much of the time. Captain Antoniel. Thank you tremendously, friends. Round of applause. Not exactly a warm one, but it's there all the same. Love Will Keep Us Together, a song written by Neil Sedaka and Howard Greenfield. And their last song together will be our last song together tonight. I may cry myself just before midnight. So if you like that kind of music, hang on till then. If you don't like it, you can really go away now if you want. You'll like this, though, is Del Shannon. He has a birthday tomorrow, and he's coming specially to sing for us tonight. Del Shannon. He had a lot of sadness in his life, according to those songs, didn't he? He was greeting about something. Little Town Flirt, that was, in the top 10 in 1963. Del Shannon, what a man, eh? Well, we normally have a competition on a Saturday night, but because this is the last one, and because, basically, of the festive season and the holiday period and the postal difficulties. No offence, post office. You're entitled to your holidays. They get very touchy, you know. You have to be careful with them. Anyway, we haven't got a competition. We didn't have one last week, so there'll be nothing to do at 10:30. There'll be about 3 minutes silence then, probably. No bad thing, you may think. How about the Monkees? Neil Diamond wrote that song for the Monkees. I'm a believer. And strangely enough, two of them, or two ex-members of the Monkees, I suppose we must now say, Mike Nesmith and Davy Jones, both have a birthday tomorrow. Isn't that remarkable? And Davy Jones, of course, is back in this country. He's been doing quite a bit of television work. Mike Nesmith, I believe, concentrates more on writing these days. Only performs occasionally in public, but writing very nicely, too. And isn't that odd? Don't you think it's strange that the Monkees television show is still being shown now and again on British television, and the youngsters seem to like it? Well, that shouldn't be. It was of its time, you know, the middle 60s. And here now, in the middle 80s, the youngsters are watching the Monkees. They should really be watching George Michael and Andrew Ridgeley. Well, second thoughts, maybe. Maybe the Monkees do have something to offer. You're the boys. The latter mentioned. This is their number two of the moment, Last Christmas.
BBC Radio 2, Ken Bruce.
My beautiful laundrette, starring Nausea Bagwash. Bring your own powder. Good morning. synchronized spitting going on here. Ray Moore wins by a short head. It's Monday again. Another week staring us in the face. Keep looking at it. We'll stare it out. It won't recover from this. It's Barry. Bye, but it's an exotic life, isn't it? Which twin had the Tony? Barry Manilow at a Copacabana. 11 minutes past 8 on Monday morning, the 27th of January, and I know how much we all love Monday mornings. In fact, I had a demonstration of that today. I was just on my way in here, and I stopped at a road junction, and a London bus rolled past. You know the way they're all lit up inside? There's enough lights burning in there to light up the stage of the London Palladium. They all look as if they're making up in the mirror, but lights blazing away inside this bus, and it's full of people all looking out the window at the car. And you want to see their faces, like a fishmonger's window. Come on, we can do better than that. More enthusiasm, Britain. Wake up. Here's Alan Jones, not only singing for us, but speaking as well.
Hi, this is Alan Jones here, and you're listening to The Ken Bruce Show on Radio 2.
Good boy, Aled. Walking in the air. It's 8:15, and excuse me just a moment. The phone is ringing. Just a sec. Hello? Yes. Yes? Yeah. Okay. Fine. Thanks. Well, there we are. And what? No, I'm sorry. I can't tell you. It was an unattributable briefing.
Radio 2 Travel News.
Okay, it was the travel unit. Delays for drivers travelling towards London on the A23 at Purley in South London. Because of an accident, the northbound carriageway of the A23, Brighton Road in Purley, is severely restricted at the junction with Stoatness Road. There's a tailback to London-bound traffic of over a mile and a half, and delays here will continue throughout the morning peak period. That's the A23, Brighton Road in Purley. Avoid it, if at all possible. And in the City of London, there's severe congestion because of roadworks, and traffic travelling into the city is now tailing back over Southwark Bridge. Snow is affecting many roads in Scotland and the Grampian region. In the Grampian region, the A939 Ballater to Cockbridge Road is blocked at Corgarth. In most other areas of the country, be prepared for icy patches. In Hampshire, road widening is taking place at the A36 at West Willow between Salisbury and Totten, which I always think is probably the birthplace of Steptoe and Son. At Totten, there are lane closures on both carriageways of the A35 Totten bypass. On the A5 in Staffordshire, roadworks at Waterloo Road, Burslem, junction with Nile Street, north of Stoke. Any more subclosures coming are causing diversions for Hanley-bound traffic. In the Greater Manchester area, sewer construction work is taking place on the A560, Altrincham Road. Yeah, altering the sewers. That's in Sharston. And at Stockport, there are diversions on the A6, Wellington Road. On the A1 in Northumberland, there's road widening work at West Linkall, north of Alnwick. And in Cumbria, there are lane closures on both carriageways of the A74 at Moss Band, 1 mile south of the Scottish border. Just the wrong way, eh?
Radio 2 Travel News.
Is it wet and windy down there at sea on HMS Victory, Ken Bruce?
It's not, but I am. Actually, it is. It's pretty horrible here today. There is sleet in the air, there are high winds, but we're all set for a happy time. Did you enjoy yourself this morning, dear boy?
I was terrified, Ken. I was scared out of my wits. But nobody would have noticed, would they?
Well, not unless they were in the studio with you, probably. We'll speak to you tomorrow, Derek.
Indeed, and good luck at sea, all you jolly sailors.
Thank you, you old lubber. Let's cast off. Yes, Radio 2 sets off on the briny. From now until 7 o'clock tonight, we're adrift. I'm on board HMS Victory, the oldest capital ship of the Royal Navy, moving shortly to the newest, HMS Ark Royal. So, come on in, the water's lovely.
Old man,
ready board on a sea cruise, appropriately enough, because we're all on here. We're on board HMS Victory at the moment. We'll be moving shortly to HMS Ark Royal, then setting off. Round the Isle of Wight, trips around the bay. Lovely day we're going to have today. I'm on till 11. Jimmy Young will be taking over the reins then. At 1 o'clock, it's David Jacobs. 2 o'clock, Gloria Hannaford. 3:30, David Hamilton. And John Dunn at 5. All of us from the seaside.
Radio 2 at the Olympic Games.
And across to Seoul now, and a very good morning to Ken Bruce.
Good morning, Dave. How are things with you?
They're better. I've had a dickens of a week. How's it been for you?
Well, I was going to ask you to tell me all about it, but I won't now, since you sound as if you've just...
It's been very depressing. You wouldn't want to know about it.
No, I've got the very strong message coming across the ether from you there. It's been a pretty good week for me. It's been a good night for this country. A good night for you and a good morning for us, if you see what I mean, because there's a gold medal to add to our list again. That was, of course, the men's coxless pairs in the rowing. Andrew Holmes and Stephen Redgrave took that for us. And delighted they looked with the whole thing. I'm not sure if we can expect too much more just for the day, but we've got some exciting stuff coming up in a moment or two. Of course, the final of the men's 100 metres. What a race that promises to be. The heats already today, the semi-finals, I should say, have been marvellous, marvellous races. And so we're expecting something pretty good in just about 5 minutes from now, just under 5 minutes when they go there. You tend to blame Vivian Stewart for everything, don't you?
Especially the weather, my dear.
It's not been bad, though, has it? I mean, you must admit.
No, I was saying, you know, the first snow for 30 years over Hollywood.
Yes, well...
And here we are.
The world has gone mad.
Our day will come.
It's the greenhouse effect. No, it's not, apparently. They say it's been like this ever since the 16th century. We just keep forgetting that the weather gets now and again.
And if it's the greenhouse effect, how comes Alaska has had their worst winter for years?
Well, exactly. Well put.
Thank you.
I'm taking all the glass out of mine, just in case. We shall speak to you tomorrow.
Indeed.
Bye, Izzy, bye. Bye-bye.
Radio 2, Ken Bruce.
Good morning. Thursday the 9th of February. I shall be with you until 11 o'clock this morning, playing all your requests. And after that, well, the world's your oyster, really. I don't know what I'm going to do. I really want to save my voice today, though, so I'm going to go somewhere where I can just stand watching things, listening to things, but never have to open my mouth. I'm going to a parliamentary select committee. It's a miracle. The miracle will be if I get all the names and addresses right today and the speeds of the records. Don't let them run on to the next track. Put like that doesn't seem very likely, does it? Hilda Gay of Bradford. Greetings to her son-in-law, Bob, whose birthday it is today. Hello to Gloria as well. They live in Bradford as well, and they need a bit of cheering up. So why not? We'll do our level best for you. And Margaret Charlton, she lives in Hartlepool, so she certainly needs cheering up. And as well as that, it's her birthday today, according to Frieda Powell of Luton in Bedfordshire. Is everybody needing cheering up or something? And why? And you've come to the wrong place. She says... Writes Frieda, have you got a fan club yet, like Barry Manilow? Well, it's not quite like Barry Manilow's, really. I mean, obviously, I mean, everybody's got a fan club, so it's a bit like Rob Wilton's Air Raid Wardens, really. And there's four of us in the little hut behind the Dog and Pullet. And three of us haven't paid our subscriptions yet. And to cap it all, the natives are revolting tonight. The Shads, as we used to say. Why? And Apache, with L. Bloomfield's good wishes. He's in Skegness in Lincolnshire. He says, that brings back so many happy days a long time ago when my sister got married at Kirby and Ashfield in Nottinghamshire. I first played that record then, still think it's the best. Of course, the best thing about your sister getting married is you get unlimited access to the bathroom thereafter. Doris Barsby of Market Deeping in Peterborough has a happy year. Delighted to hear it. Her son and daughter are getting a happy birthday greeting today. They share their birthdays for today. Richard is 18, Sarah is 21. Sarah's fiancé Mark will be 21 on February the 20th. They're to be married in July. And not only that, so that wasn't quite enough, but Michael and Doris Barsby celebrate their 25th wedding anniversary in September. No wonder they're into the drink. And hello to Charles Galloway of Pitfield Street in London as well. The Days of Roses.
Days...
Yes, I'm not entirely sure that was quite the right tempo for the song, Frankie. Yeah, not that I'm at liberty to criticise Frank Sinatra. I just felt it deserved, you know, the Days of Wine and Roses, a saddish sort of song. Shouldn't really be taken at a swing-along pace. It's a bit like hearing Ave Maria done by George Formby.
Late night listening, Radio 2, Ken Bruce.
Hello, small earthquake. Not many hurt, but let me start a little tremor in your dressing gown.
In Hollywood, the rain stays mainly out of town.
Beg Big talk from the wee girl, eh? Crystal Gale with Hollywood. I'm more of an Ealing man myself. And in tonight's Comedy of Errors, well, so it's all new, so I'd better explain to myself as much as to everybody else what's going to be happening between now and midnight. Since we're all new at this game, it'll take us a little while to get used to it. But coming up very shortly, about 5 minutes or so, we'll be finding out about massage machines. Now, please, take it easy. I mean, it is only 6 minutes past ten. Not even that. Yes, just 5.5 minutes past ten, so don't get too excited. Massage machines may shortly be on every street corner. Well, close to it anyway. We'll have the details of that. Bruce Parker brings us the first of our regional reports. Each night we'll be bringing you a report from one part of the country, one part of these islands. And tonight it's the South Coast. Bruce Parker is our man down there. We have a short story each evening as well, and to put you in the mood for that, let me tell you that it's called The Man Who Hated Cats.
He was about to move in the direction of the staircase when there appeared, as if at a summons, a large black cat. It marched briskly past Vaughan, tail perpendicular with well-being, its face wearing that smile which a pleased cat assumes. A remarkable feat, considering the flatness and inflexibility of its features. Straight up to Earnshaw it went, encircled his legs with affectionate rubbings, then stood up with its claws kneading his shins as though inviting him to pick it up.
Don't tell me he swung it as well. That story, The Man Who Hated Cats, round about 10 past 11 tonight, and each night there will be a short story at approximately that time. We'll also be taking a look at the first editions of the papers as they hit the streets, and tonight we'll be celebrating a famous birthday. We also have space for your correspondence. Letters on any subject under the sun even. But we are starting on coincidences. Remarkable, amazing coincidences that make you think, oh, really? And each night, I must tell you this, just before midnight, we'll be closing with a classic. A classic closer. One of the best of the pop canon. That's about it for tonight. In fact, it very nearly is it. Back tomorrow, when we'll have a regional report from Newcastle-upon-Tyne. Ian McRae will supply that. And Jemima Parry-Jones will be telling us about her interest in vultures. And our short story is one by Saki the Lull. Also, more of your amazing coincidences. Coming up after the midnight news, Peter Clayton with a brand new series called Jazz Parade. I'll be back tomorrow night, 10 till midnight. Join me for that. Our classic closer tonight comes from none better than the Beatles.
The long and winding road.
It's as easy as ABC. Welcome to the ABC quiz. And here's your host, Ken Bruce.
Thank you. Hello. Welcome to the ABC quiz, the multiple choice quiz with questions on a wide variety of subjects. I'll be asking three contestants general knowledge questions, and they'll be given three possible answers each time. All they have to do is choose the right one, A, B, or C. They're competing for real prizes, and there's a jackpot to be won, a highly desirable portable stereo radio. And a picture of Jimmy Young. Come back.
Hello, and welcome to the 35th Eurovision Song Contest. Yes, 35. On the brink of young middle age, really, and still showing no signs of maturity. That's probably also why I'm here to cover it. Yugoslavia is the host nation. Zagreb is the host city. And as usual, they're going to lose no opportunity to trumpet abroad the virtues of the place. First of all, they're going to take us on something of a sound trip of their cultural life. Don't worry, it doesn't really go on for too very long, but it is strange in places.
UK, it's Radio 2.